night. I've done 12 fish. This is the 12th fish. I've had two 20s and all the rest have been doubles, and I've been here since the 16th of June overdoing those 24 nights, and now I've just had an absolute epic moment. I've got a lovely common here and it's gone £28, and do you know what, you're fishing here for surprises, and this is a surprise, and I bet you it's an unknown fish. I can just feel it in my blood that it's an unknown fish, this. I don't think it's been caught much. There's no hook marks in its mouth. Absolutely perfect mouth it's got. So here we go. Do our best here, but he's quite lively. So now we have to get right down for this one. Kyle, look at it. Absolute beast of a fish. How old this fish is, it's got to be at least 40 years old. All these common smile. Got put in many years ago in the 60s. I was talking to Brian Lightwood, he's the man who knows all about these river fish. Smile, he's the one who stocked them. Yeah, these commons, who's telling me. Smile. Oh, epic. Absolutely epic, look at it. 100% smile, Cheshire, British grown, old tatty common. Look at it, beautiful, the Jan common. Yes, smile. Oh, let's get a bit more water on this now. Oh my word, what a fish, what a fish. 10th of September, at last, one of the good ones, one of the big ones. I think there's still plenty more of these left to be caught. Plenty more of these left to be caught. Smile. Oh, size of it. Smile. Bloody epic. Absolutely epic. Smile. How's that, Darren?
Brilliant.
Darren Jackson here with me, witnessing this. He's loving it. What a fish, eh, Darren?
It is. Lovely.
Happy times. Lovely days. Lovely times. Smile. Happy days, look at that, Daz. All that effort, mate. All the moaning from the match anglers. Oh, lovely times. Smile.
That'll do you.
Yes, that'll do me, mate. Proper Cheshire carp. Go ahead, mate, cut that. July. I'm absolutely exhausted. I've been in a car accident. My shoulder's absolutely whacked. I haven't been getting much sleep. I've got really bad sleep deprivation. I've been working really hard on the river. I'm nearly giving in. These floods are just... Oh man, I really, really moved any fish that's been on the Winsford stretch. It's destroying me, really, you know. It's 5 miles walking. And I've been walking up and down since May. I haven't seen no fish. Opening week, all of June, not seen anything. But
you know, I can't give in just because it's getting tough. I've said I'd give myself three straight seasons on it. It's just so tough at the moment. My shoulder is like, feels like it's gonna fall off. Right, I've done 11 nights now, and in between those 11 nights, it's baiting up, walking. So in the 11 nights, you can double that up. So it's like 22 visits, walking up and down, baiting up and looking, and then fishing for like two nights, and then one night. It's all destroying, to tell you the truth. I am really, really, really exhausted. I mean, because of my shoulder and that, I've been getting like 4 hours sleep of a night. I'm in so much pain, but you know what? I've got to keep going on, and I just can't let it get to me, you know what? You've just got to keep going, you know, when fishing becomes hard, you know, you've got to keep going, you know, it doesn't come easy, you know, when, you know, you've got to put the effort in. And as I say, no courage, no carp. Now, I'm not going to give in. There's loads of people who've come down on opening week, giving it the big and saying, oh yeah, we're going to smash you, Joe, and all that. They've all gone, you know what I mean? That's such a month and they've gone. I'm seeing them down there now, you know, they've given in. And so, it's like, I've done 11 nights now, and last night I was out, and I don't believe it. You know, you've got to understand, I pick two spots on each stretch. So you've got like the Red Line stretch, you've got the Cavanna stretch, you've got the Salt Aim, the National stretch, and you've also got the Salt Mine stretch. Now, it goes up to Meadowbank from Red Line. So, you know, that's like, you know, four stretches. So on the four stretches, I've been beaten up on two spots. Two areas on the four stretches, so you know that's eight baiting areas. So what I'm doing is I'm baiting up three times on each one, and then fishing them and spending two nights on them. And last night, like I say, it's the 17th July, I've seen nothing all winter when I've been walking down there. I've seen nothing there all May, nothing June, and now the 17th of July, it's just picked me up, really. Like, it's given me a bit of faith, because I'm nearly giving in. I'm really, really nearly giving in. I was out last night, and I've heard a crash, and I've gone, Jesus Christ. I've seen where the waves have come from, the boat, like the waves off the crash, where they've come from, and it's a little bit further down from my baiting area. Now, I'm going to keep these locations quiet, you know. It's too hard, and it's too much hard work to be going, oh yeah, go here, go there. I'm getting so many emails regarding the river and this, that and the other, and you know, you got to put yourself in your own shoes, yeah? If somewhere's fishing hard, yeah? And like, you're like, not catching, then all of a sudden, I've heard a fish last night. Now, I've gone down this morning and I haven't seen nothing. My first light where I seen the crashing, and then I've reeled in, gone down, couldn't see it. So it's the evening now. And I don't believe it. I've just looked at the bush, and I've seen just waves coming off the bush. And I'm thinking to myself, a bird in that bush or what? So I've grabbed a handful of stones and I've gone down and I've stoned the bush, and no birds come out. But guess what? Bulrushes were like that, bush, 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 bush. So I've found some fish, and I reckon there's about between 3 and 5 fish there. Now, I've been applying the sticky bait krill. It's a good bait, and I've been putting halibuts in with it. I've had 10 kilo of krill, and I've had 20 kilo of pellet, and I've broke it up into half kilos, baiting up, spreading it out between the 8 swims. You know, it's like, it's been awkward and it's been difficult, but you know, the sticky krill's a very good bait and it's just not doing it. So I've found these fish now. I've got some bait coming up. It's Active Bait Solutions, lobster crab, rock lobster, sorry. I'm sorry if I'm getting words wrong and everything else. I'm so tired, it's unreal. So I'm gonna apply this bait now to a few spots and see what goes on. I've just seen a really good common. It's just, you know, it was 25 plus, it just rolled. So, you know, I've got no bait left now, so I'm gonna have to give it like just a couple of days. It's coming tomorrow, my bait. So, you know, I'll put some of that bait in. And I've gone with a different approach because I had bream on the 20 millies and I had a couple, to say the truth, I had four slabs since opening day. And they've all been between 6-7 pound, you know, decent sized bream, but I just need bigger baits. And also now I haven't got a freezer, so I need a shelf life. So I'm relying on Active Bait Solutions rock lobster, because you know it's made by Jeff Bowes, and what Jeff doesn't know about bait ain't worth knowing. And don't get me wrong, like last year I caught 10 fish on Scott's SAA bait, crab oyster, and it's a cracking bait, but you know it's a fresh bait, and I can't use Scott's bait because it's like it's not fitting in with my fishing. It's not because I don't think it's a good bait, because it is a good bait, and so is sticky bait krill. Scott's bait, you know, it's really good, but it's fresh and he only does 20 millies. So I'm going with the Active Bait Solutions rock lobster because, you know, it's got crunch in it. You know, he put things in it so when they're eating it, they're crunching it. It's like eating shells, like what they eat. So I'm going with 20s and 24s, and they're going to be shelf life. I'll tell you now, I've seen Jeff's bait before. And you put his shelf life next to a freezer bait, you wouldn't even know any difference. So I know I'm letting you know, because I'm telling you about the bait and everything, you know, is because, you know, it's relevant to the fishing, you know, it really is. And, you know, let's just don't know anyway. I'm keeping my fingers crossed that, you know, I have a couple of fish now. I've actually found some. You know, I haven't seen no fish on this river since September the 10th, I think it was, when I had that 28 pound common, and since then I ain't seen nothing. So you know, my heart's really low, and I'm really like, my head's gone, you know, with this river bit now. You know, I'm tired and 4 hours sleep and everything else. So I just hope now, like, you know, these few fish are fine, you know, something will turn out anyway. So what an out, really. Let's hope we get some fish on the bank.
Oh, fucking hell, fucking hell. Just fucking lost one, bastard. right in the edge as well, right next to me. It's just gone in the fucking big fucking plank of wood at the edge. It fucking towed off like a fucking steam train had it in the middle of the river. It's fucking non-stop fighting, and then it went down to me left, and I fucking fighted it. It was just in the edge, and it's fucking done me on a fucking big, massive fucking piece of wood. Fucking bastard. Look at the fucking state of the oak. Look, see if you can see. What a fucking state of that oak. Jesus Christ. It's a good fish as well, man. Fuck me. Bastard.
Wow, how mad was that? Lost the plot there when I lost that fish, and guess what, it was that bloody common that I seen as well. Oh, just don't believe it. Just, you know, this is, you know, every time you see fishing, you see all the good side of it, you don't see the bad side of it. You know, I'm trying to be a proper angler, you know, I'm trying to let you see everything that goes on in fishing. You know, it's not easy when it goes hard, and you know, I could have easily hid all that from you all and everything else, but you know, I've put it on my Facebook for the lads to have a little laugh at it and that, like, you know. But you know, it's one of them, innit? You know, stuff happens, you know, when you're into something and you're passionate about it, like. But yeah, I've lost that fish, and I've been applying the rock lobster. Yep, and I was right. There was 3 to 5 fish there. Oh, yeah, there was. I've just had a 21 off it now, 21 mirror, an 18 pound common, and a 19 pound mirror. And the 19 pound mirror, he was proper shitting the rock lobster out. So, yeah, they're having it there on that spot. So, yeah, happy days. You know, it's been my birthday. I've reeled the rods in for a couple of days, and you know, I've got drunk and had a few good days kip and that, like, and I'm back on it now, you know. So I'm on 3 now and lost 2. So, you know, let's see what else goes on the river. I'm really made up of finding those fish. It's just like, yeah, get in there. You know, it's a long time since September 2020 to see no fish, and then all of a sudden, see, you know, see those 3 to 5 fish, and then the first fish I have, I lost it at my feet, and it was like that. It was a 25 plus common, and it was like, you know, it got to me, you know, and I was really tired. I had sleep deprivation, you know, I was having bubbles in my eyes all the time, all the walking, and you know, it's 5 miles that stretch, you know, it's chaos. You know, and I've got to keep the location, you know, quiet. You know, basically what's happening now, Jan's dropping me off, and then I'm getting off again before the boats come, and I just as the boats come on. So, you know, it's quick in and out. You know, I've scaled all my tackle down, you know, so basically, you know, to help my shoulder. You know, I've got back basically nothing with me, really, but next to nothing, you know. You know, it's hard work, this river now. It's not like it was years ago. I used to come down and batter it and have like 4 or 5 fish in like a night and stuff like that. You know, even in the winter, I remember I come down with Chris Cook one year, and like, you know, we went up on the Northwich stretch. I think I had 3, he had 2. Then we went on the Winsford stretch, we had 2 each. And this was in the middle of the winter, like, you know. You know, I've been on the winter, on the weaver a bit, you know, in the winter, and I've smashed it, absolutely smashed it. I used to pull off petty pool and like I'd half 10 and then like go down there and fish till half 4 and smash it like 2 or 3 fish. But now it's a different river now. It's, you know, and it's the way I like it. You know, you got to put the effort in. You know, you can't just turn up and just fish and catch, you know what I mean, how it used to be. You've got to put the effort in, lads, and you know, put effort makes rewards, and you know it's got underneath my skin, but you know I'm back on it, like, you know what I mean, I'm up, I'm getting out, I've sorted it out, I've sorted like my sleep out, and I'm fine now, it's great, you know, everything's back, everything's tickety-boo, I'm on free fish, you know what I mean, it's like, you know, at 20 as well, 21, you know, and I'm sure that, like, you know, it'll come right, you know, I've got till September to try and improve on what I've done last year. You know, it's going to be hard, like, you know, 12 fish and at 28, Jesus Christ, it's, and I think I lost two last year as well, so, you know, it's sort of like 14 bites, like, you know what I mean, so, you know, we're on five bites now, you know, really hard, but it's, what the problem is as well, is like, you're hitting the fish and, you know, you got your marginal snags, but also, you know, I'm reeling in sometimes and I'm hitting snags in the middle of the river, now, that's not normal. These floods have absolutely killed this river, the stretch of river. You know, they've gone up into the top flash. Loads of lads on top flash are like, they're having 30 fish where they're usually on like 5 or 6. Bottom flash, you know, there's a lot of fish coming out of bottom flash. It's just unbelievable how many fish are coming out of there. But, you know, it's having to slow down. So I'm thinking now the fish have moved out of the flash. And, you know, the ones that, you know, the reason I've seen these five fish, they might have, like, moved out of the flash and then come back into the river. But I swear to God to you, I mean, I've never fished this river and it's been like this. But you know what? It's mega. I love it. You know, the heritage fish, the old historic fish, you know. So they're worth catching, you know what I mean? Singles, doubles, anything. And I'm really enjoying doing it, you know what I mean? Even though I... You know, you've seen how bad I've been and everything else with the car accident, sleep deprivation and everything else. But I enjoy it. You know, it's what pushes me on. You know, if it was easy and like no, you know, easy fishing, I get bored with it. I like a challenge. I like it. I like carp fishing. That's the way I like carp fishing, because it kicks you and it kicks you and it kicks you. I haven't been kicked like that for years, absolute years. You know, I'm like 30 plus years in there now, you know, 32 years been carp fishing. I haven't been like that since I was a kid, you know, and it's boss though, you know what I mean? It's what keeps me going, you know what I mean? I like a challenge. I don't mind doing a bit of easy fishing, like just because it pays for like the time and the effort you put into it. Yeah, you know, getting your rod bent, it's what it's all about, you know what I mean? But, you know, a bit of hardcore fishing, I love it. Absolutely love it. When it's made me cry like that, that's it. It's getting it. You know what I mean? I ain't giving in. You know, so, you know, let's see what goes on. You'll see a couple of photos of those three fish coming up and then whatever else comes on. I don't know what's going to happen, you know. But I'm going to stick at it because, you know, you got to keep on keeping on with hope in your heart. No carp, no courage, no carp.
Hold back the river so wide. And stop for a minute and see where you hide. Hold back the river, hold back. Once upon a different life.
Let's get this life foot strain out and get it on the bank for you. This is a dead.
Oh. Right. Oh. There we go. Oh. Oh. September 6th, on our Giggsy's birthday, and on the death of Mick, the great carp dog. Yeah. This is a dedication to that Mick. At my boilies, went through my rods and everything. Come in, Jan, on this. This is a proper Cheshire Warrior, this. 1965, these fish were put in here by Brian Lightfoot. It's the Lightfoot strain. Come in, Jan, have a look at this. Look at this for a beast. Hey, what a beast. Oh, all golden brown here as well. Oh, the size of these pelvics. And the pecs on that. You'll notice this one again because of a little tuck in its pec. Mm-hmm. When your hands are in your right hand.
And if you remember as well, he's got a lovely little nudging mark here. Oh, he's a proper old warrior. And I think this boy's seen a few hooks. Have a look at that for him. He's had a few people caught. Been caught by a few and made a few happy. But I don't think at this size. Look at this. He's spitting out all kinds of mussels. Oh, look at him. He's the true warrior. True Cheshire River warrior. Oh, I'm over the moon. Oh, here we go. 27.5 pound. Here's to you, Mickey. Proper true warrior carp dog. And a proper true old warrior carp for you, mate. Dedicated to Mickey. One of the Lightfoot strains. Here we go. How's that, Jan?
Lovely, isn't he?
A warrior, isn't he? Big old warrior like me.
Yeah.
no courage, no carp. Ignore all the knockers, just carry on with your courage. Keep fishing with hope in your heart. Keep on keeping on. Yes, there we go. Oh, other side. Oh, have a little zoom in on this other side, Jan. Here we go. Look at that. Absolutely perfect. Oh, look at it. The paddle on it. It's bigger than my hand. The pecs on it. Wow. Four fingers. Look at him, he's huge. He's a huge river fish. Don't be getting jealous now, Jan. Here we go. Yes. Yes. Dixie, look at him. Come here, boy. Oh, he's behaving now. There
yes,
you go, Stu.
It's gorgeous, hey. Isn't it?
One for Mickey, eh? Yeah. We'll never forget him, mate. Never. Lovely times. Absolutely lovely times. All the hard work, all the sleep deprivation, miles and miles and miles of walking, tons and tons of bait. Oh, rock lobsters proper rocking the river now. Yes. And we've still got, what, 2 good months left before it goes all cold. Oh, look at it. Fantastic. Magic. Over the moon. Yes. Rocking. Yeah. Come on, girl. Let's get him back. Let's get Mick back. The Mick coming. Oh, the Lightfoot strain. Tell you one thing, this Sonic gear, top of the range. Yes. These two all the knockers, knock that one. Here we go, Mick. Off you go, Mick. Look at that. Yes, Mick.
Good catch, that. Well done.
Made up. Is our Giggsy on his birthday as well?
Yeah.
Say hello, Biggs. Hello, Giggs. There you go. Gonna go in. Thanks, Jan. The bird, now it's your turn.
I know that they say that some things are better left unsaid. But he doesn't like you, only talk to him, and you know it.
Don't act like you don't know it. these things people told me keep messing with my head. Should have picked honesty, then you may not have flown it. Don't have to say what you did.
I already know.
I found out from him. Now there's just no chance. You and me,
you'll never be.
And don't it make you sad about it?
Told me you love me. Why did you leave me all alone?
All alone.
Now tell me you need me. Can you call me on the phone?
Can you call me on the phone?
Girl, I refuse. You must have me confused.
Well, it's October the 8th now. What a lovely fish that 27 and a half was. Absolutely brilliant. Rounds it all off really, doesn't it? I love it. Absolutely love it. Right, since he had that 27 and a half, I've done another 3 nights in September. And I never had nothing. I tried a new swim, done 2 nights in that, where I'd seen a couple of fish through the year. And I never had nothing, never seen nothing. And then I had another trip on a spot where I've had fish, never had anything, never seen nothing. And then all of a sudden, bottom flash was kicking off again. People were catching multiple captures and everything else. And I thought to myself, here we go. They've gone on to bottom flash already. So I was a bit stuck really, and I've had a couple of nights off, went in between my shifts and work. Not done much really, you know. I've had 10 days away from the river, because it was just stagnant. It was still. I've waited for the low pressure to come back in again, so the river will start moving, colouring it up, and had a bit of wind, a lot of wind come in, and you know, it was like I'm waiting for that to go away. And the south's coming now. I was thinking of a new area or an old area, so I thought to myself, right, Carper's Corner on the national stretch is good with these conditions, and we reduced some high pressure just after the low pressure, and lucky enough, I was off work. So I'm on Carper's Corner. So there he is. My first fish and my 11th fish off the river this year, 2021. Proper little character, this fella. We've got to get him on film because, you know, it's a bit special really, isn't it? You know, and I reckon, by the way, this is like my 29th night on the river, and he's my 11th fish. So, and I've lost, I think I've actually lost 4 now, or is it 3? Not too sure, doesn't really matter, but you know, the takes have been coming in, and it's all been on the rock lobster. So, here we are. Probably years ago, we've all been either caught up in keep nets, or like back in the 80s. Used to get quite barbaric people. Here we go. Plum bum. Here he is. Lovely little bugger. See? Sorry about the camera. Not getting my head in and all that, like, but it's not that relevant, really, is it? You know? Here he is. You can tell him, you know, he's got that plum bum. And his pecs are very, 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 very small and damaged, almost like they're rotten. There we go, little plum bum, fish 11, 29th night, up 2 miles from where I caught it at the beginning of the year. Crazy stuff. Anyway, there he is, little stonker. Let's see what goes on for the rest of the year. Ah, fantastic. Little plum bum. carnage. Sorry, absolute carnage. I had plum bum. I thought there weren't going to be any more out. So, 4:15 this morning, I had a long mirror, about 16 pounds. So, just thought, slip down the sling, it'll be light in 2 hours. Next minute, I had another common, then another common, both of them 18 pounds. And at one stage, I had two landing nets full, because I always carry two landing nets and a sling. For this reason, you know, you're on the river, you know, it can be consistent if you're on them. So so I've got three fish landed. I took a nice shot with the first fish I caught, the long mirror at 16 pound in the dark, and then the other common I had was 18 pound. I took a photo of that just as it was getting light. Then I took another photo of that common and put it back, and then right, here we go then. 20 and a half pound common. you gotta record there. You know, 20 pound commons, you know what I mean? Especially off the river. You can't like not do it really, can you? Here he is. It's a lovely little fish. It's perfect condition, all of these river fish. You might have had, you know. On the rock lobster again. There you go. Little belt. There you go. 20.5 pound. He's got a bit of a gobby. He's got a bit of a drop lip, got jaw as well. You'll notice this one again. And people will notice it again anyway. There you go. Just see his mouth. Just see it there. See his bottom lip there now. If you see it on the other side, you'll see it. There you go, another 20 off the river. That's what. Grab on the other side. And he's like 4 or 5 20s now. Oh, here we go. Bit more water, calm him down. This is the batter's side, really. He's got a little bit of a scale missing here on this side. And he's the gob, a broken jaw, as they say. And he's been a few wobbly bowels. Proper old warrior. Yeah, life foot strain. There you go. You see that now? Yes. It's great to have a 20 off the river. You know, such an achievement, really. They're really hard to catch, you know, at this size. Especially over the years I've fished it. You know, 20s are 20s, but these river 20s, just solid fish. And this is the fifth fish since 5 o'clock this morning. It's 8:30 now, and I've been absolutely marathon carp fishing these fish. Don't half fight, I'm absolutely exhausted. Proper battered me up. There you go. Lovely times. Get on the rock lobster. They love it.
Your eyes hold back the river so wide. Stop for a minute and see where you hide. Hold back the river. Hold back. Once upon a time.